So when people think about stress, they usually think of some upset with their spouse or a problem at work or a loss of a loved one, things like that. But there are also nutritional deficiencies that can keep you in stress mode. But what I'm going to talk about mainly is, when I talk about stress, I'm going to talk about anxiety, which is more worry. Depression is more, I don't care, I'm apathetic, or you have the blues. You're weepy, you feel like crying all the time. So you have the macronutrients, which are the vitamins, minerals, trace minerals, amino acids, and fatty acids. And then we have the micronutrients, okay, for each category. Now, out of all the macronutrients, these are the most common micronutrients that will keep your body in a stress state. And so let's just kind of go through them. Vitamin B1, this is probably the most important one. And if you were to take it when you're stressed, or you have this feeling of nervous anxiety, within 3 to 4 minutes of taking B1, you're gonna feel very calm. And if you haven't tried it before, you should definitely try it. I recommend nutritional yeast because that has the natural form of vitamin B1. When you're deficient in B1, the body cannot relax. It develops this nervous tension, restless leg syndrome, irritability, things like that. So B1 is probably my favorite one because it creates such a dramatic effect. I remember one time in practice, I had this husband and wife that came in and they were fighting in the waiting room. So I put one in one room, I put the other in another room, and I said, go to your rooms. And then I gave them some nutritional yeast. And within a few minutes, they were chilled out. They were happy. So I was able to put them together and they didn't kill each other. So B1 is very, very important in countering high levels of cortisol. Now, the next most important one, as far as vitamins are concerned, it's a deficiency of D3. And normally, a deficiency of D3 will cause depression, but it can also cause anxiety and stress. Why? Because vitamin D is not really a vitamin. It's a hormone-like compound. So basically, you're helping regulate cortisol when you take vitamin D3. The combination of both of these works really, really well. Now, as far as your minerals go, magnesium is at the top of the list. So if you're deficient in magnesium, it's going to keep the central nervous system in a state of stress. And so when you take magnesium, you're going to feel calmer. So a lot of people take it before they go to bed. A lot of people take Epsom salts in their bath, and that's magnesium, and they actually can really chill out and feel very well. A lot of the magnesium you get in your diet is in the leafy greens. So when you consume enough leafy greens, which also, by the way, has potassium, it'll create a calming effect on the nervous system. Okay, then trace minerals. Out of all the trace minerals, zinc is the number one trace mineral that will help counter stress. It works on a lot of different parts of the body, including the central nervous system. Shellfish, zinc. All right, now we get to amino acids. L-theanine and L-tyrosine are my two favorite amino acids that can help balance the flight or fight mechanism. You have the autonomic nervous system composed of the parasympathetic and the sympathetic. These two amino acids can actually bring up the parasympathetics and take you out of that flight or fight sympathetic dominant mode. So they're really good to calm the nervous system. And then we get to fatty acids. Out of all the fatty acids, DHA, which is an omega-3, is the best one for stress. And if you're deficient in DHA, which is in fish oil, and actually fish and shellfish, it can have an effect on your central nervous system. Okay, so what causes these nutritional deficiencies? Consuming a lot of refined carbs and sugars. Experiencing stress in general. High cortisol can deplete you of certain nutrients. If you have insulin resistance, because you have consumed a lot of refined carbs, you won't be able to absorb these as well. So you're going to have to take more until you fix this by doing keto and intermittent fasting. And also lack of sun, like in the winter, you're going to be deficient in vitamin D, and that can increase your stress and even increase your risk of getting depression. One last point about stress. If you're not on the ketogenic plan and you're not doing intermittent fasting, you should do that because ketones can actually put you in a state of calmness. And I put a link down below to learn how to do it. Thanks for watching. So if you're enjoying this content, I have a favor to ask you. If you wouldn't mind writing an unbiased review, I put a link down below for more information on how to do that. and thank you in advance.